Okay, dear students, we will start our lectures of apiculture, lecture number 4. In apiculture, lecture number 4 will continue as previous the digestive system of honeybee. In last we have seen the mouth parts and its food feeding type. Now we will see how the digestion is takes place in mouth parts. Last time we have seen that the honey spoon or labellum is used to take up the honey or pollens or nectar, and it has a small mouth parts which are aggregated at the anterior. These are the mandibles, maxillae, then maxillary pulp, its parts glossy, paraglossy, and this is one. And next to that we will see these all mouth parts are aggregated to the anterior side and are elongated. Of them, the tongue is quite large, or we can say we can call it as a ligula, which works as a tongue, therefore it is called as ligula, which has a spoon like depression and generally called as labellum or honey spoon. We have seen in the previous figure. So this carries a mid ventral groove or food channel or proboscis through which nectar is sucked or food material is taken in, and while feeding the tongue is extended into the nectary of flower, or we can say at the base of flower there is a space where the nectar is collected or nectar is stored, we can say naturally, and that is sucked up by the spoon, or we can say ligula. So for that, labial pulps and galea form a protective sheath around the tongue and which helps to suck the nectar. So nectar rises up through the food channel by capillary action, and sucking action of the pharynx and shortening of the tongue also helps in this process. And from the pharynx, the nectar is processed into a thin-walled crop or honey sac. Crop is working as a organ where honey is prepared, or we can say the honey sac is there, where it is chemically converted into honey by the secretion of the salivary glands. Means the food or nectary or whatever the food is taken up by the bee is stored in the crop, where it is processed by the salivary action of the cells and the secretory action of the crop walls. The nectar and the pollen material and saliva mixes together, and by chemical action it converted into honey, and then it is regurgitated and collected in the honeycomb. So this is the process of formation of honey by using salivary glands. If you see, the structure of salivary gland is quite simple, that there is a syrinx. Just below the pharynx there is a syrinx, and followed by a common salivary duct. Then it has branches. The first pair branches are at the both sides, therefore it is called as paired glands. So these are the paired salivary glands. So first pair of cephalic glands, as this part is in cephalus. Then second is at the posterior side, and from the cephalic region it is quite diverted to the posterior region where thorax is there, and therefore these glands are located in the thorax region, so called as thoracic gland or second pair of gland. This is first pair of gland, this is second pair of gland. As the first pair of salivary gland is located in cephalus or head region, it is called as cephalic salivary gland, and as it is located in thorax, it is called as thoracic salivary gland, or we can say second salivary gland, first and second. So if note will be there in the examination, you will be able to write something like that. Saliva in honeybees is secreted by two pairs of glands. We have seen in this diagram or figure. both discharges their secretion finally into the common median duct, which is located at the center in this common mediated duct. First pair of salivary gland lay in the back of the head. This is at the posterior side of the head, while the other pair is in the ventral part of the thorax. This is the ventral part of the thorax. Means this part is located in the ventral part of the thorax. The first pair of glands located in the head are referred as head glands or cephalic glands, or generally called as first pair of gland. These glands are in the form of flat masses of small pear-shaped body. These are the small masses of pear, circular we can say, shaped bodies in which saliva is stored. Then their ducts unite within the head with a common duct. These all the ducts unite and forms a common central duct, which is lies from head to the thorax, and therefore it is called as thoracic duct or thoracic glands, where these glands are located in the duct are thoracic. This is bifurcated posteriorly in the thorax region. So this is about the salivary glands. So the second pair of salivary gland, which is in the thoracic region, which develops from the silk glands of the larva and correspond with the usual salivary glands of other insects. Actually it is not such a gland, but it is like a salivary gland. And the thoracic glands consist of masses of elongate or tubular sacculus at the end of branching ducts that lead into a pair of reservoir sacs. A pair of ducts run forward from the reservoirs and unites just behind the head in the common median duct, and the common duct then enters the neck foramen of the head and empties into the salivary syringe. So in this way, this second pair of gland secrete its salivary secretion into the head region, or into the salivary secretory syringe, which is located at the mouth region. So this is about salivary glands. Now feeding, how the bees are feeding. While feeding, the bees extend its ligula or tongue into the nectary of the flower. Then the elongated labial palps and gillet, or we can say galley, or we can say slit like organ, makes a protective sheath around the tongue, and the nectar rises up through the ventral groove or the food channel by capillary action, and then the muscular sucking pump action helps to suck the material by shortening of tongue into the pharynx, because the pharyngeal muscles suck up the food or nectary into the mouth, and then it is sucked up and passes into the sac, or we can say crop, honey sac or crop. Then this is about all about the head region, where we have seen antennas, mouth parts, compound eyes, then maxillary pulp, labial pulps, honey spoon, salivary glands, everything we have seen. Then we have seen the feeding mechanism by using all these head organs. Now the second body part is thorax. Thorax is the second major division of the body, where legs and wings are located. The thorax has three segments. On the anterior prothorax, a middle mesothorax, and posterior metathorax. Prothorax, mesothorax, and metathorax. These are the serial three segments of the thorax. Each segment bears a pair of legs. Means three segment bears six legs, therefore it is called as hexapod also. Whereas meso and metathorax bears a pair of wings. These two last thoracic segments bears a pair of wings, means four wings. One pair is flying wings, second pair is protective wings. In this way, the first abdominal segment, propodium, is fused to the thorax. The first abdominal segment is propodium, and that is fused to the thorax and looks like a continuation of the body segments. Now, in thorax, legs and wings are there. So we will see the all legs, which are of what type and what function do they perform on the body of honeybee. So these are the three legs: prothoracic leg, mesothoracic leg and metathoracic leg. Three legs are performing three different functions and have three different structures. So all the three pairs of legs are densely covered with hairs, which are variously modified to collect pollen and to walk. Each leg consists of five podomeres. Podomeres means divisions or sections. These are the podomeres: coxa, trochanter. These are podomeres. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So these are five podomeres, like oblong coxa. This one is the coxa. This is coxa, first part. Then a short trochanter. This is a short trochanter, second division. Long femur. Then this is a long femur. These are two short segments. This is long femur segment. Third segment is femur. Then tibia and phyojointed tarsus. Then tibia. This is tibia and phyojointed tarsus. This is the tarsus. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Tarsus. This is tibia, and tibia have central spur or velum or brush for cleaning the antenna. So therefore, it is called as antenna cleaning organ or cleaning brush. Then phyojointed tarsus, and at the end a polyvillus is there. This is a polyvillus. At the end, polyvillus or cushion is there. We can say cushion, and a pair of claws. These are the two claws. Two claws are there at the end of the tip, or at the tip of the leg, we can say claws. And the polyvillus secretes a sticky substance which makes possible the bee to walk on a smooth surface. So where this polyvillus, or at the end of the last body segment, have some secretory material which helps to attach the bee on the smooth surface, like glasses or likewise stones. This is about the first pair of leg, or we can say prothoracic leg, mesothoracic leg and metathoracic leg. So this is a common distinction. We have seen that there are five joints. Last joint have five segments. Then all these segments have different structures, different size, but the podomeres are same. So we will see one by one how, what is the difference between these three. So first is the prothoracic leg. This is the prothoracic leg. It consists of five podomeres, as usual: coxa, small trochanter, third elongated femur, fourth is long tibia, and last is tarsus or tarsomeres, we can say. So see, an oblong coxa, a trochanter, a long femur with hairs for carrying pollens. These are the hairs which are used to carry the pollen. Small particles or small organs of the flowers used as food, pollens. Tibia having a pollen brush. This is a pollen brush or cleaning brush, we can say, made up of stiff hair and a movable plate, velum. This is a velum. This plate is movable like finger. So as it moves and can be clean antenna or collect the pollens. So this velum is there, and this is the notch, or we can say cleaning brush here. So this is metatarsus, tarsus, pollen brush. These are the organs of prothoracic leg. And the velum plate on the costal end of tibia can close on a semicircular notch on a proximal part of the tarsus, to form an antenna comb. So this works as a comb. If we will keep this here on it, it cleans comb like. So this works as a comb, we can say in B. So forms antenna comb, used for cleaning antenna. So the function of first pair of leg is to collect pollens and to clean the antenna. Long bristles on the tarsus, these are the long bristles on the tarsals. This is the tarsus. Long bristles on the tarsus forms a pollen brush. This is a pollen brush for removing pollen from the front part of the body. So as we clean our body by front hands, likewise bee is using this prothoracic leg to clean her front area. So this is second podomere and this is third or metathoracic leg. So we will see now second mesothoracic leg. It has five podomeres, as like the first, or we can say prothoracic leg. The tibia bears a pollen brush on its inner side and a pollen spur on its distal end. So pollen spur is used to remove the pollen from the pollen basket and wax from the wax pockets of abdomen and transferring it for comb building. So this is the spur which is used in collecting the pollens, cleaning the pollens from the head, or to remove the wax plate from the body. This spur is used, and this is pollen brush for cleaning the body. This is also pollen brush. Now third pair of leg is quite modified than these two pairs, because it is used as a pollen basket. This total is pollen basket. Pollen basket. This is the pollen basket, and this is the pecten. It works as a lead. Then pollen packer. This is the pollen packer, used to pack the pollens inside, or we can say auricle. So these are the organs which helps to collect, gather the pollens in this leg. So this leg is works as a pocket to collect the pollens. Therefore, the third pair of leg is called as pollen basket. In each metathoracic or hind leg, the outer surface of the tibia carries a depression called the pollen basket, which is partially covered by rows of long curved bristles arising from its margin. Distally, the tibia terminates into a row of stiff spines forming pecten. You can see here the pecten. This is the pecten. This is a round pecten. Then the proximal upper end of the metatarsus bears a concave plate or lip called as auricle. This concave plate is called as auricle, and the auricle and the pecten working together form a pollen packer. These two organs are forming a pollen packer. As the pollen is collected, they pack the pollen in the basket. The inner surface of the metatarsus bears a series of transverse rows of hard bristles. Means inner surface of the metatarsus shows some hard bristles to push the pollens inside with forcefully to pack the pollens in the basket. So these are used, the hard bristles are used in forming the pollen combs. So they are collecting the pollens and put it into the pocket. While flying from flower to flower, the worker bees gather pollen on its body hairs, which are combed by pollen combs, and the pectens scrape the pollen from the combs, while the auricle push up the pollen mass into the pollen basket. And in this way, this metathoracic leg plays a key role in gathering the pollens from flower to flower, comb it with the help of pecten and auricle in the pollen basket, and collect it and bring it to the hive. So these pollen baskets collect the pollens, and when the baskets are full, the worker bees return to the hive, where the pollen is removed by the spores of metathoracic legs to store in the hive cells, because there are some storage cells in the comb or hive. So where there the pollens are stored. The pollen combs also remove wax scales from ventral abdominal gland cells and transfer them to the mandibles. So in this way the collection of pollens is taken up by the legs. So these are the first organs of thorax, that is legs. Second organs are wings. So there are two pairs of organs of flight called as wings. So this is first pair and then another is second pair, two pairs of wings. So first pair is called as forewing and second is called as hind wing. So these are narrow, membranous and transparent, which have a rather modified and reduced venations. These are the venations, very thin and reduced venations, and the forewings are larger than the hind wings, and a row of 20 minute hooks. The hamulli on the hind wings fit into a groove in the back of the forewings to cling and make up attachment useful in flight, so that both wings of each side locked together and the organs of flight can vibrate more than 200 times per second, 200 times per second, and they carry the worker up to 3 kilometers from the hive at a speed of 10 to 20 kilometers per hour. And during flight, wings may vibrate up to 400 to 450 times per second. So this is a very active and fast movement of the bees for flight. So this is about the first pair of wings and three pairs of legs. So next part will be observed in, or we will study in the next lecture. So till then, now see you.